So now I'm going to send Leonidas the Wrathful to Ajay to siege it. In fact, I'm going to try and break it down and take it within a few turns, because there's a small garrison here. And then, just to make sure, obviously Leonidas doesn't get attacked, I'm going to send up my Spartan army here, led by Dorios. I'm going to send him to attack Aeson of Terrace, which has caused him to retreat. Now I'm going to continue this fight, and I'm going to attack both these smaller armies with my larger Spartan force. Alright, so here is my battle line. I have, I'm trying to fight this as historical as possible, so I have my regular Spartans on the left, followed by my elite Spartan units, followed by my general's bodyguard, in which I have two Acontisti on either wing, ready for a flanking attack, and I have my cavalry here in reserve. Alright, so let's start the battle. The enemy has camped on the hill, which is no big surprise, and their reinforcements are coming in from the north, through the woods there. I'm going to try and not make the, I'm going to try and prevent them from coming together. So I'm going to actually, my Spartans are hardy units, so I'm going to try to actually run them up this hill to engage the enemy force as quickly as possible and destroy them, and then I'll be ready on the hill to face the other one. So let's see how that works out, eh? So now the Toxotai aren't really going to be a threat to my elite Spartans, or actually my entire phalanx. My shields are towards them, which means they get double their shield bonus versus missile units. So really, this small force isn't really much of a threat. I only have to worry about the cavalry and make sure they don't hit my Toxotai. I mean, not my Toxotai, my Cryptia. Okay. And here comes the Greeks. So, I'm going to engage. I'm going to leave my general out of this. Actually, these are regular hull plates. I should be able to crush them relatively easily, so I'll engage two there. I'll engage, you know what, the rest of my elite Spartans, four units, right up here. I'm going to make a small change. I'm going to take my regular Spartans, and I'm going to run them over here as a guarding action, because the enemy is a lot closer than I anticipated. And I'll have my Cryptia stay where they are for right now. Alright. I'm going to bring my Cryptia around on either side to try and do a flanking attack. I'm going to bring, let's see here, I think I'm going to bring my cavalry on the left here to help out these particular Spartans. Oh, I should run these guys. Run. There we go. There we are, the door these guys have already broken, which means I can continue my advance up. Okay. Well, alright. Heavy cavalry has come up here too. I'm just gonna bring my Cryptia a little bit more safer on this side. There we are. Okay, so here come my Spartans to engage. Okay, what do I have here? My regular Cryptia. Who's back here? Ah, my guarding action. Actually, these guys should be moving up a little bit more now, I think. There we are. Okay. There we go. All right. Uh-oh. Alright, here comes the Terran teams on a flanking attack. I'm going to bring up these guys here to meet them. And I'm going to bring these guys here to meet them there. I'm going to have my Crypti up here to pester the enemy. I'm going to have this unit move back this way. Alright, and here we go. Round two. Okay. Well, I still have my three Spartans trying to chase down this cavalry, which isn't really going to work. Alright. I'm going to have my cavalry go after the cavalry, obviously, and I'm going to have these Spartans join the fray up here. They'll be a reserve line, I suppose. Okay. What do we have here? Alright, so they've broken on this side. Gonna pierce through on this side. Well, my Cryptia hit these guys from behind. Okay, another break. I'm gonna bring these elite Spartans down. I'm gonna bring these ones up to engage here. I'm gonna bring my Cryptia down. How are we doing down here? Pretty good. Okay, I'm just gonna reform my line here. They've all broken. Gonna bring them down this way. How's my cavalry doing? They'll do alright, it looks like. These Aegon Tistai, I forgot about them. I'll just bring them around this side. And, yeah. I think this is pretty much wrapped up. I don't want to be too overconfident, because we know what happens when that happens. Let's see here. Okay. There we are. Okay, so now I get to use my cavalry as a good old-fashioned wrap-up troops. So, let's see here. I'll have one go after that unit, and this will go after this routing unit. So for those of you who don't know, the Tarentines were actually a Spartan colony, the actual only Spartan colony. The founders were freemen, but not actual citizens of Sparta, and also sons of unmarried Spartan women, bastard children, frankly. And the reason why there were these bastard children were because of the Messenian Wars. Sparta needed to rally as many troops as possible, and allowed these unions to exist so they could have soldiers. Now, after the war, the soldiers were nullified and they had nowhere else to go, so they founded the city of Taris. Taris is also named after the son of the Greek sea god Poseidon.
Alright.
Alright, so that was a clear victory. I had over 1,509... I had almost 1,500 kills. The enemy had about 370 kills. So, with that big victory, I'm going to bring these guys just right back into these mountains again. And I'm actually going to build a fort. this is kind of just a stopping point, I suppose I could say. I just want to make sure the enemy can't get through here. And in case they come with a very large force, it gives me some time to bring up some reinforcements. But speaking of reinforcements, now that this army in Athens has been retrained, I think I'm going to bring them up to be... I have to retrain a few of them still. That's alright. I'll just take all the units that don't require retraining out. Let's see here. There we go. Excellent. And they are going to head up towards the battle line as well. We'll bring them right here to begin with, because I'm not sure whether I should have them go up through Lopactos or continue the assault in the north. I'm also going to send in, I'm going to see if I have any young governors who also want to be generals as well. Let's see here. Uthalex, he's 49. He's 37. Clearchos the Fearless, eh? Let's see here. Oh, this guy's young, but he's also the commander of Moronia. Let's see here. He's a good attacker. He's a proud veteran. He's publicly... He's a proud veteran? What? He's 16. Oh, alright, whatever. He must have gotten a fight when he was 15. Monarchist, natural-born leader. Well, you know what? Actually, he has a lot of potential. Let's bring him up and help him join. Let's see here. He'll join with Leonidas's army right there. Excellent. And you know what? I think we'll bring Clearchos up here as well. He'll command these this reinforcing army. There we are. He's a good commander and a good defender, which is good. And he's fearless, which is fantastic. Unfortunately, he's a poor infantry commander, but he's a great cavalry commander. So, well, there's that. Okay, and in Eretria, we're going to build ourselves a large temple of Ares. So, I have a suitable husband. First, you know, he's a good commander, he's sober, and he's skilled bureaucrat, and he's young, but he's also a democrat. I don't want any sort of democrats messing up my conversion rate, so I'm going to decline.